seeing, you know, we are basically type checking. Actually, syntax only give you the grammar portion, but semantic analysis, you are checking the type checking, parameters all right, formal parameters, then the intermediate code generation. The intermediate code generation, various computer code optimization tools are used. There are many other tools. I might miss three other tools, and you will see these similar tools will be again used whenever the final code generation. So there might be different way the tools would be used. It's like date code elimination. I have certain portion of your coding, and you might wonder why the coder actually write date code. Actually, it is not coder's responsibility. Sometimes code is copy paste from this where, or it may be include library and all this. So, and maybe there's a macro definition. So macro definition might generate certain date code that is impossible for programmers to detect. So compiler act as date code elimination, code movement also, because you know the we have already omitted that stage. Maybe next class we'll touch that topic, that pre-compiler directives. We directly start from the lexical analysis. Before lexical analysis, the pre-compiler's pre-compiler's directives, like you see if and def, macro and all these pre-compiler instruction, that is another block with a pre-compiler which takes care of it, and which macro it copy paste inline code, and that might generate date code and other things. Strength reduction, we will come to it. What is strength reduction? Strength reduction sometimes say a multiplication by 2 or multiplication by 3 may be changed by compiler, multiplication by 3 by adding 3 times, that is simpler multiplication. Sometimes time complexity will be more, and so sometimes we change the multiplication with addition. Not always possible. Common sub-expression elimination, name itself, this compile time evaluation, say constant folding, like if you have 2-3 constants, if you have a you try to compile, I always try to put anything any put constant is there if it is available before that. Constant propagation, we'll touch upon the other techniques also. So today we are basically a little discussion of the semantic processing. Maybe we can do at the end of the class, because semantic processing is very vital, but it is less complex. I found the understanding LR1 is the most toughest topic, or LALR, because you know LR1 you have to understand LR0 first. Without LR0 item collection, you cannot understand LR1, because you have to see the follow of the variable on the left hand side, and then how to combine those states into LALR. So LALR and LR1 is the toughest, and then to understand LR0 also you have to understand LL1 very good, because LL1 will give the concept of fast and follow. So then shift reducing, parsing and all. So after this is the toughest topic, then comes the semantic processing, because you know the certain declaration rules like integer, floating point declaration, or func C, we declare the function. We can write function body later. We have to formal declaration of the function. Before that, this checking the actual formulas all is done by the this our semantic analysis, and this cannot be coded like any variable declaration. It cannot come under context free grammar rule, deterministic context free grammar rule. And in the meantime, again and again, I am telling you that every compiler generally handles context free grammar, deterministic context free grammar, unambiguous deterministic context free grammar. Because, and there, after semantic analysis, you know there are L attributed, S attributed, more or less, we have decided that it will be L attributed grammar. Because ultimately it will be declared. You are thinking about C++ and Java. Python is a different, because it is a dynamic type. So it ultimately Java, C++ is L attributed, except terminals, they will be synthesized. Then we go for the formal parameter check, and then the all these there are many other techniques will be there for this thing. And this thing we have already covered. Now we'll discuss about these. And another thing I before forgot to mention you, that in C language, in Java also, you use the volatile keyword. Just to remind you why you use volatile keyword, where we generally that area programmer write volatile keyword in front of a memory, that signal to the compiler that they should not compact the code there, because intentionally volatile keyword should not be compacted, so that the processes, because when the program will run in the CPU, we call it processes or threads, they should check that volatile memory that should be allocated in your main memory, and that should not be compromised. So that should be always available. It should be look up maybe the global section. Definitely that memory should not be, the memory can be in stack or heap. Stack is, it is growing that way, heap is growing that way. Heap memory, we got it by malloc and calloc, and then beneath that your if you see that this is the memory frame. The first is the program in a dot out, that is pure read-only version, it will load on. Then the global memory, that it can be accessed. Then the global, this portion global initialized memory, then the global uninitialized, then the heap, and then the stack, and then the your main function. So I'll come to this. So, but your volatile keyword is very crucial, that this kind of optimization should not touch it there. So this is, today we will cover this topic. So quickly go to the next here. Yeah, this is, so we are here, machine independent code optimization. So we have already covered intermediate representation. We are here, machine independent. Then you will see certain tools, whatever I mentioned, may be used here also. Like directed acyclic graph and other techniques also, it can be used both. So please, and code generator depend on your target machine. So we'll come to this. Yeah, this is I got it one book. I'll send that book to you, the full version. It is very interesting about compile implementation in Java. That way what I have told, that see, if we have compiler, then you have to so many compiler to design, but if you go for intermediate code, it is M plus N, so less complex graph. So we generally go for this, okay, until and unless there's special purpose for it. So we generally go for this intermediate code. So it can be run at anywhere, say Spark machine, Mix machine, or Pentium, or ITNM, any machine. So we'll go for intermediate code. I've taken this book. This book is available, I'll send it. Classifying optimization is based on scope. The scope is very vital in your programming language. It's based on positioning, based on dependence with the target machine independent. I've told you again and again, we generally always go for machine independent also and machine dependent also, both. Because roughly give you the idea, machine independent we have understood, and machine dependent means you have a very finite registers, the registers count in varies from RISC chip, like ARM chips and all this, and our CISC chips like Pentium, this thing. So number of registers differs. So you have to calculate which variables you use to put them into the give register allocation, then the programs will run faster. So all these things will be definitely will be discussed. Date code elimination, very understood, that say I is equal to 0, then this code will never be reached. So this is a stupid thing, but it might come. It is not programmer intentionally wrote. It can come from various macro and all these things. So compiler should be intelligent enough to see if there is unreachable code, because this portion of the code will be never reached. So that is the final. So a lot of compiler, there is a lot of advantages which is there. So it is that. Here the same thing, I take the example from internet, various slides, so that here you see eta I is equal to 1, and global is a declaration to date, global 2 actually that will be used, return, so only these two will be there. So this portion, this anything declared after return will be there, it is not used. So whether it is user, so the date code elimination is one very good thing about the compiler. This is the same thing, date code, nothing great. I took it from number. This is dates to, this is east. So same, almost same the previous slide. This is interesting, constant propagation. What is constant propagation? See here. See, we have n10z2 for then i is equal to n. So if we found that if we already got the variable actual constant, you have already initialized it 10, so you should, the compiler will automatically put 10 here, and compiler already comes to c is equal to 2, compiler put a 2 here, so ultimately it will run much faster. Actually, whenever it will go to the machine dependent or machine independent, both ways, it will run much faster than this code. So this type of thing will be done by the compiler. So compiler is very intelligent. In fact, nowadays compiler with lot of other intelligent stuff are there. So this is very interesting. But that is called constant propagation. If the value of a variable is known to be a constant at compile time, replace the use of the variable with the constant, because compiler is always trying to program should run faster. In fact, that is the tradition. Whenever the C compiler design in the basic language C is designed by Dennis Ritchie in the 1961-62 on PDP-8 machine, at that time they have hardly 8K RAM and they have to reuse the code, so they all are mutable, changeable. Not changeable things come from Java and Python, and they always try the program should run fast. Program should be not running fast or be stable, or program should check dynamic time whether it is valid or not. This is not checking, is traditionally is not that easy. Like array, it is programmer's responsibility, the array of size say 100, so initially static allocated there, and if the it goes the 101th element, it will come to proscreen, because C language and C compilers traditionally designed that way, so it is very difficult. Only from Python, Java and this thing, they allow the dynamic type. So at the runtime, speed is not very important, because we have now very powerful computer. Here now, the more checking is done and more reliable system is being built on Java and Python than traditional C, C++. That is, I have to mention that traditional compiler design favors always maximum checking at the static time, at the compile time. So they always try to put not a variable into the running code, like here they replace with the actual constant value. That is the traditional bias of this kind of C, C++ compiler, Java also, because they are static typing. But the scenario will be different in the whenever interpreted in Python, because there will be, it will be more robust. We may not require that amount of fastness. So that is constant propagation. It is traditionally, it is very strong, the compiler up there. Constant folding, almost like similar, but it is same. If operands are known at compile time, evaluate expression at compile time. Almost same, it's called constant folding. Like if we have this, we always multiply and use this later, not go for every time, go for multiplication. So that is called the, if you constant folding is a, that is a peculiar name, so that you can calculate all the try to have less computation in loop and all this, whatever it can count it earlier, that you can. So that is constant folding. Common sub-expression elimination, there's various tools that is, you can understand. Like here, E is equal to B plus C, C is equal to B plus C, so we give here T is B plus C. But again here you see, D is equal to B plus C. This C is different than, so now this C is this C. So here, we will not replace D by T. Here is equal to D B plus C. So only these two code, you might argue why is it 3 lines, is it 4 lines, but this will run faster because this is simple replacement and here actually computation, it can be maybe plus, star or it may be more complex. So this code will run faster, that this code will not be eliminated. So if we have common sub expression, that is the name of the common sub expression, we can compiler can detect it, compiler can detect it. But I have told again and again, if any volatile key area is there, you should not do any touch this. Compiler should not touch that portion. So that is the purpose of using volatile in your database writing code. Say volatile area generally used for getting online access from your point of sale terminal or on your various modem port or maybe threads are communicating through that. That portion of the code you should, compiler should not touch. There should not be any modification should be there. So that is common sub-expression elimination. Then it is copy propagation. Name is simple. See if x is equal to y. Then we go for y like this. If anything copy, then we go for the copy. This is, I do not find much interesting. Maybe I can found a better example with this. I got it. So I this because in this area of the code, Aho's book is sometimes is so long. So I try to give some interesting example so that you can remember. Dead code elimination. I have already told this is say like this. It is not used like here. This code is not used. So it is eliminated. X is equal to so like this. See, this is interesting. Liveness analysis, I'll come touch today and more elaborate on it because this is a runtime environment that is more used. Dead code. So, some of the tools are used at the both code optimization, intermediate and final optimization. This is interesting. This is unreachable. Same thing. I got an interesting picture that is the reason like this. Eliminate code that never be executed. Like if debug is equal to 0, so it will not be executed. So no use of this code. In debug never be 1 because I have initialized it if debug is 0. So that is this portion of the code. But this, you know, this code can comes from various compiler instruction. So many operations. I have touched constant folding, constant propagation. I have not covered tail call elimination. I couldn't find good example. If a good example, I'll touch next day. Redundancy elimination, I have touched. Dead code elimination, touch. Loop invariant code motion, that I have discussed back. Because any loop portion which is not invariant, so it go into the upper. So a lot of fastness comes. So that I have discussed. Loop invariant. Next day I will do this. So any code which is not changing in the loop, we will take out of the loop. Loop splitting I have not discussed. Loop fusion I have not discussed. Strength reduction I have discussed. Strength reduction means whenever you are multiplied by 2 or 3, you better multiplication can be changed with addition. Arrays, characterization I have not touched. Inlining is kind of a macro, I have not touched. Synchronization elision I have not touched except for the volatile. Cloning I have not touched. Data prefetching, parallelization I have not touched. Because parallelization I have touched little bit. Okay, we'll see how to interact. Okay. So there's optimization techniques, not a single technique. And another thing I am telling you, this is almost like NP complete problem. If you cannot the best possible code, if you run, if you want to get best code, you may take various, it's incomplete problem. Anything this, because you are optimizing these, then you have to need optimize this. So there is always a, you have to put stop on it. So there is no end for betterment of the ultimate target. It's more or less there is some bound, so because the compulsion should not go again and again. So that's it. So that is various techniques may be there or not. Loop collapsing. This is loop collapsing. See here, say a two-dimensional things, you can put it in a, like in a pointer, we can make a single loop. So instead of two loops, like I is equal to 0 to I, j and j is equal to 0 to 100, so we can make a pointer, this I make a single loop, this is loop collapsing. This is example, loop collapsing, I try to get more better example. This one I had to mention about the volatile keyword. It is obvious that volatile is very important because various states are communicating one particular area in your primary memory. That should be in your global area because the global area everybody can access. If it is in the stack or heap, it is difficult. So global area, and you should not optimize it. So that is, you should not touch the volatile keyword. Yeah, now these are the, go to the chapter 7 of the our book, main book, Kaho, the runtime environments. You all know that here the, it is written in reverse way. In many other books, you go to the code, go top, same thing. Either you go this way or that way. This code is your actually A dot out. It should be not changeable. Whenever your or A dot out or exe file, that would be read only. Though it is in a RAM, and you know there is a, if you have a RAM 8 GB, this is a particular window, maybe maximum 512K or maximum 1 GB like this. You can, because if multiple program code is running, your computer is multiple access, and even if your 8 GB RAM, you have maybe virtual memory, hard disk, another 32 GB, generally 2.5 times is the recommended. See, if you have a 8 GB, then you have 2.5 GB, then another 20 GB is a virtual memory. Then your actual 8 GB, this may be maximum 512K or a chunk contiguous area. And if you take the bottom start here, that is the convention. Generally, some books is bottom. Say here it is code is that way, that way. Say it's a zero and it is increasing like FFFFFF. This is the all F's there, this is all zeros there. Your BIOS should be here at the top. Then the OS, operating system, maybe Linux, maybe Windows. Even the operating system may have, definitely they have also stack and heap. Then the free area, we can, one chunk is this. This is the code that is read only. Then the static memory allocation. Static means the global initialized memory. Global uninitialized. Global initialized memory, which memory area you declare global and initialize it, and global memory which you have not initialized it, static memory. Then the heap area, you know, C convention by malloc and calloc, you can allocate the heap. The heap advantages, heap doesn't, once you create it, it is there, it will not taken away. And you know the Java, Python, this all allocation from heap, there is a Java and Python, there's a garbage collection, and that will be there in our chapter 8 garbage collection. And then the free memory, the stack comes here. Here is your program going into function, then the function, then recursion, then stack, convention stack goes here and heap goes here. So if they meet, your program will hang on, it will give arbitrary error and all these things. So that's it. So our objective should be that it should efficiently it is loading. It is the duty of the code to generate this binary code after optimization, load it and all these things. This is, you know already that depending depend on registers, how much registers depend on ASIC type or Pentium, and there are level 1, level 2 cache. Generally, L1 cache are cheap. Some machines have L2 cache is also cheap. Physical memory, virtual memory, and all. So this is the good optimization at the machine level, they will take care of this with heap management. This is interesting, that is in a garbage collection portion. In C and C++, you have to deallocate memory, the programmer's responsibility. Now it is in Python and Java. There's some program which runs in every millisecond, say garbage DC, garbage collector. It will check whether there is any external reference or not in the object, in the heap area. If there is not, they will delete it. No pointer from outside is interesting. So they are, though they are linked, but they are not outside linked. So your garbage collector should check it. That's it. That is another garbage collector's role. In the heap area, this is definitely heap. This cannot be stack, because stack is only one dimensional, it can move and back. So there cannot be any gap in stack, and only heap area. There may be some gap because memory will come, and after garbage collection took away, then you have to typical compacting this so that you can have a, if you have a large object comes, you can allocate from there. This is the garbage collector can do in the like Python, Java, and this kind of this thing. Yeah, this is where we are. A source program, front-end analysis, this analysis portion are done. After the last stage here is semantic analysis, syntax-directed definition, syntax-directed translation, then any error and all. Symbol table is heavily used. There's intermediate code. There's various techniques of code optimization, certain techniques.